So today I wanted to see if ChatGPT can write code for a game in Roblox, and the first thing that I have to check is if ChatGPT can even write code that works. So I'm gonna order ChatGPT to write a function in Lua that returns the minimum value in a table of numbers. Okay, let's see if this code works. I'm gonna copy this code and paste it in a script in Roblox Studio. Let me run this function and give it a table of numbers. So 4, 5, 1. And also let me print the result. Let's see what it does. 1. Okay. All right, it printed 1. Let's see, what if I add 0 in here? 0. Okay, so clearly this function works perfectly. That's pretty cool actually that ChatGPT can make that. Now let's see if ChatGPT has an understanding of the workspace. So I'm going to order ChatGPT to make a script that makes a chair out of parts in the workspace. Alright, so this is the code. As you can see, it knows what a seat is. It understands that a chair might have a backrest. It has 4 legs. So let me copy this code and put it inside of Roblox Studio and see if this even works. I forgot to anchor the parts, so I'll just fix that. Now I added the anchoring to all the parts. Let's see if it looks good. Alright. Wow, that actually looks good. Yeah, it's not like the chair that you see every day, but this could actually be a chair. Let me just flip it and let's see how it looks like. Oh, I think I know what it was trying to do. So, if I flip it like that, and then I shift these things a bit higher. Now, this is a chair, guys. ChatGPT generated this. I did not help at all. I'll give it 10 points for that. Now it's time to see if ChatGPT can make a game on Roblox. So this is a very simple order. Write code in Roblox Lua for a Roblox game. Apparently, it needs more information. I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to tell it to choose a random genre. Okay, it chose adventure game. Now it should write a game based on that since it chose that genre. Its response was that it can't make an adventure game because it's a very complex task, but it then said that it can make a puzzle solving game. And so this is the code for it. I'm not gonna read it. It should work. So let me copy this code and put it here in the script. Now let's see how the game runs. Oh my god, I'm so excited. Oh wait, no, I'm an idiot. I have to play the game. Okay. Okay, wow. This is pretty nice, actually. So I wrote this code a while back that basically compares two games and gives a percentage, and that percentage will be higher if the two games are a closer match. So if it's 100%, the games are identical. And if it's 0%, they have nothing in common. So the first game that I'll compare this game to is... As you can see, the code returns 68.9%. That's actually really good. This game could be a front page game because it is a very close match to Bed Wars. Now I'm going to compare it with... With Adopt Me, the function gave out 43.5%. And that's okay, I guess. It's not the lowest percentage, but it's also not even close to the highest percentage. So the last game that I'll compare ChatGPT's game to is... Guys, you won't believe what just happened. So I gave the algorithm ChatGPT's game and Brookhaven RP. And the algorithm came out with 100% match. You know what this means? This means that ChatGPT just made a copy of Brookhaven RP, a replica. And this is insane because ChatGPT made that game in less than 100 lines of code, and Brookhaven probably has a million lines of code. Therefore, ChatGPT can be used to quickly make AAA games on Roblox. Oh my god, I think I'm starting to see it. What the heck? I think ChatGPT is just too powerful. It has to be stopped. Okay guys, I found ChatGPT HQ, and their servers are in one of these two buildings, But just to be sure that ChatGPT is truly dead, I'll destroy both of them. Okay, fire the missiles.
Ah, what a beautiful day. Nothing could go wrong. Am I right? Whoa, what's going on? Someone help me. Ah.